Hey guys.
Hey people.
Oh good, the bell.
Flippin' physics.
Ladies and gentle people, the bell has rung, therefore class has begun. Therefore, realize today what we're gonna do is we're gonna check a claim on this box. We're also gonna define the term kilowatt hour. So, on this box of energy efficient light bulbs, it says that we could save $108 in energy costs per package. So per three light bulbs, we could save $108. And it says, if you check the asterisks, which requires you to go on the back, it says, as compared to using a 65 watt bulb at 12 cents per kilowatt hour. So clearly we need to know what a kilowatt hour is. As you can see, this is these are 15 watt light bulbs, but they replace 65 watt light bulbs. So we're gonna take a look at what that means. So, we have three light bulbs. The power for each light bulb is 15 watts. Turns out I actually have three of these light bulbs in my kitchen, so this is a good exercise. We can figure out how much we save in our kitchen. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna assume that in our kitchen that we have these light bulbs on 3 hours a day. That's what we're gonna assume. So, 3 hours every day is when the bulbs are being used. Now, this is a common mistake for students to make, is to assume that there are 24 hours in a day. And I know there are 24 hours in a day. Billy, don't question me on that one. I know there are 24 hours in a day. At least, pretty darn close. But the thing is, the light bulbs are hopefully not on in my kitchen 24 hours a day. So this is a sticking point for students. Realize that you need to get over that. You need to realize, okay, it's how much the light bulbs are being used or whatever appliance we're talking about is being used. Speaking of appliances, you should be aware that in the United States, all the circuits are at 120 volts. If you're in a different country, it's going to be a different number, but in the United States, we're gonna assume that we're gonna work with 120 volts every time we're talking about a household circuit. So 120 volts is the electric potential difference in a standard household circuit in the United States. Our goal is to figure out how much we've saved. So that's actually gonna be the difference in power. So it says we're replacing a 65 watt light bulb with a 15 watt light bulb. So the final power is 15 minus the initial power, which is 65. So the change in power is 50 watts. And that is negative because it's money that we're saving. It's gonna be money that we're not spending. It's energy that we're not converting to heat, light, and sound. Let's actually start out by doing a slight detour. We're gonna actually figure out the resistance of one of these light bulbs. Remind me, Bo, what is the equation for the resistance?
The equation for resistance is the electric potential energy equals the current times the resistance, or delta V equals I times R.
Great, so we're gonna rearrange that to solve for the resistance. Resistance then is equal to the electric potential difference over the current. But unfortunately, we don't know the current. We know the electric potential difference, but we don't know the current. So does anybody have any other ideas as to what we could use to figure out the resistance of one of these light bulbs?
We could use the equation for electric power.
Yep, that's right. We can use the equation for power. And if you remember, we have three different equations for power. We have one of them is power equals the electric potential difference squared divided by the resistance. So we know the power for each one of these light bulbs, and we know the electric potential difference that is going to be in because it's in a household circuit in the United States. So we can solve for the resistance.
It's going to be the electric potential difference squared divided by the resistance, which is equal to, in this particular case, to 120 volts squared over 15 watts, which works out to be 960. 960 what, Billy? Ohms.
That's right, ohms. Bobby, what's the symbol for ohms?
An upside down horseshoe, because all the luck fell out of it, because it can't hold soup, for example. Right, Billy? Yep.
Very good, an upside down horseshoe. At this point, we're gonna actually drop the negative because we know it's going to be money saved, so we're just gonna take the absolute value of the change in power. That's gonna be equal to 50 watts. And we're gonna solve for, we have three bulbs, so we're actually gonna multiply that number by three. So three bulbs means that the power is going to be equal to 3 times 50, or 150 watts. So this is the power for three bulbs. Remember, for three bulbs. And this is the power that we save for three bulbs. So now our goal is to figure out how much it costs to run these three bulbs 3 hours a day. So we have the amount of watts. Let's convert it over to kilowatts. So we have 1,000 watts on the bottom, 1 kilowatt on the top, and the power ends up being 0.15 kilowatts. we need to get to kilowatt hours, so we're gonna multiply that by our 3 hours per day, 0.15 kilowatts, multiplied by our 3 hours per day. This means that we have 0.45 kilowatt hours every day. So that's how much we use every day, 0.45 kilowatt hours per day, assuming that we have our light bulbs on for 3 hours a day.
Daddy?
Yes, Ryan?
Can I be on one of your videos, please?
I'll think about it.
Okay.
Jeannie, what are you doing here?
I'd like to be in one too.
Oh, okay. I'll think about it. That was just plain weird. What were we doing? Oh yeah. We were trying to figure out how much money it would cost to power these three light bulbs. The company that made the light bulbs gives a pretty good estimate at a cost of 12 cents per kilowatt hour.
So at 12 cents per kilowatt hour, all we have to do is multiply this by our 12 cents per kilowatt hour. So 0.12, that's in 12 cents per kilowatt hour. So we're now going to multiply this by our number of days in a year, 365.242 days in a year. So 365.242 days in 1 year. Days cancel out, kilowatt hours cancel out, and we're just left with dollars per year. Is how much we're gonna save per year for these.
That works out to be $19.723 per year.
So I guess let's estimate at how many years they think that this would last. Because they think we could save $108. So if we take the number that they claim, $108, we multiply it by the reciprocal of what we got here, 1 year over $19.723. Dollars cancel out, and we will figure out how many years these would have to last for us to save the $108 that they claim.
That ends up being 5.476 years.
So they'd have to last approximately 5.5 years for us to save $108.
That seems reasonable.
So now we need to take a few moments and look at this term kilowatt hour. Let's just write it down and let us convert it so we can make it into something that makes sense. Kilowatt hour. First off, Bo, convert from kilowatts to watts for me.
There are 1,000 watts in 1 kilowatt, so we need to put kilowatts on the bottom so they cancel out.
And now, Billy, convert from hours to seconds for me.
There are 3,600 hours in 1 second. No, wait. I got that reversed. There are 3,600 seconds in 1 hour. So 1 hour on the bottom and 3,600 seconds on the top.
So it turns out that 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 3,600,000 watt seconds. Bobby, what's a watt? Because this doesn't make any sense to me. What is a watt?
A watt is a unit for power, and power is a rate of energy. So it's energy per time, or joules per second.
Exactly, and notice what happens here. The seconds actually cancel out, and it just ends up being in joules, which means 1 kilowatt hour is 3,600,000 joules, or 3.6 megajoules.
Which means kilowatt hour sounds like a unit of power because that has watts in it, right?
Sure.
Okay.
Yes.
But it's important to realize that kilowatt is actually a measure of energy. It's not power. It's not energy per unit time. It just works out to be energy because all of the time actually ends up canceling out. So 1 kilowatt hour is 3.6 megajoules. It's just a term that people use to define an amount of energy. And it's important that you understand that this is a conversion you have to be able to do. Nowhere is this conversion going to be given to you. Instead, you actually have to be able to do this conversion. Anytime that you are going to use this, you would have to prove it. It's a relatively simple proof, but it is an important one. It is important enough, so you do need to make sure that you do this.
Got it.
Oh, man.